How can one university or one person help solve a global threat like climate change? At UB, it's all in the numbers. We have hundreds of buildings and vehicles and thousands of people. Every action we take every day impacts the environment. The university is making progress in its goal to become climate neutral by 2030. We've reduced our carbon footprint by 35%, but we need to do more. Our UB scientists say the next 10 years are critical to limit the most devastating effects of climate change. So UB has evolved its climate action plan with 10 key strategies for the next 10 years. UB's 10 and 10. First, UB will put a price tag on our biggest greenhouse gas emissions. That includes pollution from every campus building, from our air travel and how we commute day to day. Facing the true cost of our impact on the environment is great motivation to do better. In a few years, the way we power the university will get a lot greener. UB currently has solar panels on the ground and on rooftops, but soon we'll install a lot more and generate 15 times the solar power we have now. By 2025, 100% of our electricity will come directly from clean, renewable sources. Filling up the gas tank will soon be a thing of the past as the university moves to create an electric UB fleet. That includes the buses that shuttle students, the vans that move around campus, even the car that delivers your pizza. The utility plants that heat and cool campus buildings are a big operation. So UB is investing in new, more efficient, and centralized technology. Our goal? Zero carbon heating and cooling. Landfills are stark reminders of how much we throw away. Materials account for 40% of America's climate footprint. UB is looking at better ways to limit waste. That means smarter decision-making in the amount and type of things we buy, and finding more ways to reuse and recycle, so less food, plastic, and other materials are sent to the landfill. Our buildings house a lot of activity and burn a lot of energy. UB is making a greater effort to conserve with new and better technologies and programs to help us change what we do day to day. We want to reduce energy use by 30% and create a culture that's more responsible and cares about conservation. Most days, a steady stream of single occupancy cars come and go from campus. So we want to green our commute by supporting more options like public transit, ride sharing, biking, and electric vehicles. Food, what we grow, what we cook, and what we waste all produce greenhouse gases. UB is now measuring the carbon impact of our food systems, and it's not an easy task. But that knowledge will be critical as we work to cut that impact in half by 2030. There are times we produce carbon emissions that we don't have the current technology to limit. In those cases, UB will purchase carbon offsets. These are investments in local projects that actually reduce greenhouse gases. Offsets are things like planting trees or weatherizing homes in low-income neighborhoods. It's a way to create flexibility and also hold ourselves accountable while creating positive change in the Buffalo community. Developing this climate action plan is a big step, but we also need to measure our progress. So we'll turn to UB researchers who are experts in the field. They'll find innovative ways to analyze how we're doing, improve our efforts, and guide us on the path to a climate neutral campus by 2030.
With the leadership of Governor Cuomo, and with the innovative, aggressive measures like those laid out in UB's climate action plan, SUNY will continue to lead New York State towards a more sustainable future.
Each of us plays a critical role in upholding UB's commitment to environmental stewardship. I look forward to working with you to foster a culture of sustainability for our university, our region, and our world.